Dogs have a long history of living and working with humans dating back nearly 100,000 years. Today, nearly 50 million Americans wake up with their dogs as part of the family. But for many of us, they have a much larger role than great companionship.
Hi, I'm Myra Burloff.
I'm Stacy Burloff, and this is my service dog, Billy.
When people think of what a service dog does, their first thought is the typically trained tasks of opening doors or turning on light switches. But in 2000, when Stacy slipped into a coma in the middle of the night, her service dog woke us up. We later learned that Stacy had meningitis and would have died that night had it not been for her dog.
This is Billy. When people meet him, the first thing they ask is, "What does he do for you?" My immediate thought is that he got you to stop and talk to me. When I first met Billy, he came to me on the very first day. He put his head on my knee, and there was just an instant connection between the two of us.
You've had a dog that saved your life. Having an animal that could save thousands of lives because they're trained to sniff out bombs or to smell something that's dangerous in the air. How wonderful is that?
Because of him, I no longer feel invisible. He makes people see me instead of just the wheelchair.
Because of him, we all live a fuller life.
My name is Lowry Heisler, and I'm general counsel to a policy analysis firm, so I need to travel all over the world. Spencer is my balance walker dog who keeps me walking safely without falls. Federal law affords us the right of public access, so he goes with me wherever I go, from the grocery store to the Supreme Judicial Court. Because he needs to be reliable and confident in his tasks, his trainer rejected 260 dogs before settling on Spencer. This caused a long wait for me and also hugely increased the cost of the dog to me. Spencer doesn't make my disability disappear, but he gives me a better life, and I can do my job because he does his job.
Whether destined for military or civilian life, there is a shortage of purpose-bred dogs and increasing demand for them. There are many genetic tests that breeders use to produce healthier puppies and predict outcomes such as coat length or color. This collie demonstrates the breakdown between rough and smooth coats, as well as the difference in colors of tri, blue merle, or sable. We can predict what they will look like, but can we predict how they will think?
Despite decades of pedigree analysis and responsible large-scale breeding programs built around a dog's natural ability, the training success rate for service dogs hovers at only 50%. This leads to significant issues including wasted training dollars, puppies pushed into roles in which they cannot succeed, unmet client needs, and in the military, dogs that cannot fulfill the elite requirements to protect and serve. The clear and present need is to breed dogs for predictable performance, but there are no genetic tests for behaviors to help us decide which puppy will succeed for military operations, sniff out explosives at the Super Bowl, or serve as the arms and legs of a person who needs a wheelchair for mobility.
Hi, I'm Jessica Kensky.
I'm Patrick Downs.
And we're here today to talk about my service dog and best friend, Rescue, who's with us here today at the Broad Institute.
We are survivors of the Boston Marathon bombing.
The first time my family and I met him was the fall after the bombing. And it was like, I've never adopted a child, but it's how I imagine that feeling. You know, you found out about him and his name and where he was bred, and I received pictures before I got to meet him in person. And so it was kind of this big built-up moment, and he just made me laugh.
When he came over to Jess and to see the smile on her face and the way that she laughed and the way that us as her family got to observe that moment and laugh with her was something that we hadn't experienced in such a long time that it felt like we were laughing for the first time in our lives.
I did not anticipate all the emotional added benefits, which is not necessarily his main function, but it's kind of an added benefit of having a service dog, especially after an enormous trauma. They call it a partnership, and it really is a partnership where Rescue takes care of me and I take care of him. So there were a lot of intended improvements to my quality of life, but then far more unintended or unexpected benefits to having Rescue. And he's been probably the most significant step in our recoveries. Speak! Good boy.
The Theragenology Foundation's mission to promote education and advance research in reproductive medicine led to a wonderful collaboration with the American Kennel Club to establish residencies in the University of Pennsylvania, The Ohio State University, Auburn University, North Carolina State University, and University of California, Davis. Recognizing the need for new tools and technology to study genomics, the Theragenology Foundation has now partnered with the Broad Institute of MIT and Harvard.
The Broad Institute is a world-renowned genomic institute launched in 2004 by Massachusetts Institute of Technology and Harvard University in collaboration with the Eli and Edith Broad Foundation. Staffed by leading genomic scientists and equipped with cutting-edge production platforms and analysis technologies, the Broad's primary mission is to use genomics to advance our understanding of biology and treatment of diseases.
My name is Eleanor Carlson. I'm the Director of Vertebrate Genomics at the Broad Institute, and I'm also an assistant professor at the University of Massachusetts Medical School. I study canine genetics. I've done it for a very long time, ever since I was a PhD student, and I'm really interested in figuring out how changes in genes actually influence behavior in dogs. With the Working Dog Project, we're taking the first steps on the path to predicting temperament and working skills using cutting-edge genomic tools. The goal is not just to advance scientific understanding for the greater good of both dogs and people, but also to help create a more effective programs for working dogs. We need to evaluate the canine genome as critically for predicting behavior as we've done for predicting diseases. The success of a program like this could have enormous impact on the well-being of working dogs and the people who rely on them. It's important that we invest to broaden our understanding of working dogs
because they provide a wide range of critical services.
From protecting our troops in the battlefields,
to monitoring health, to providing independence and confidence to their human partners.
We train dogs to guide people with a trauma out of a nightmare, because we not only help people who cannot see, but also those who've seen too much.
As veterinarian and Desert Storm veteran, my dream is that every American who needs one of these exceptional dogs has access to one. We need your support to help realize this dream.